Before we even start, know how to hold your brush. It is not a pencil. You hold it loosely, you hold it higher up, you keep the tail pointing more at the ceiling. It's a very loose and gentle touch. You don't press it down, you let it glide across the paper. Welcome to watercolor painting. Taking care of your brush makes for a good painting. Keep the hairs all pointed in the same direction so your brush doesn't get all tangly and snarly. Bouncing it on the bottom of the cup or jar of water helps get all of the paint out of the brush. You can see the paint is now in the cloud of water and not so much in the brush. Too much water will tear your paper, so brush off the extra drops on the side on the way out. Brushing your brush across the color to mix the color into the water keeps the brush shaped nicely as well. You see, I pull it across, lift it up. If you do it rapidly, it looks like stirring, but that's how you keep your brush lined up. You can even shape your brush to a nice point by turning it as you brush across each time. A little bit of a turn looks like a nice sharpened pencil almost. You'll also notice how tiny an amount of paint I have in there. A little goes a very long way. Also notice that green, how far that goes in this picture as well. Having shaped my brush, I can get right into that corner very easily. And I'm painting with wet paint on a dry background. That is called wet on dry. The paint will stay where you put it if the paper is dry and the paint is wet. Now again with the green, you can see how much green I get out of that tiny bit. Shape the brush, I can get pretty big brush into a small pointy point. And press the brush down a little wider for the wider areas. So next is the wet on wet watercolor painting technique. I brush off the excess water again so I don't make a puddle, but just get a very thin layer of water painted onto the surface of the paper. Be careful not to brush too much either with water or paint, or you'll wear a hole in your paper. When I apply paint to that wet surface, wet paint onto wet surface will swim around. They call this wet on wet watercolor painting. And it's to make soft changes in colors. The colors will actually do what's called feathering or bleeding, where it spreads across that wetness. This is fun to do a variety of colors and watch them blend softly into each other and softens up your edges so it looks a little bit like a smoother transition of color rather than a hard edge. It's a nice soft edge. I like to use wet on wet for gradual changes of colors or for changes across what really was a smooth surface on that base. But the smooth surface had some ups and downs with the lines that went vertically through the vase. So it kind of keeps that smooth but changing surface. It's a fun way to blend colors. The next technique is wax resist. Crayons are made mostly of wax. Wax and water do not mix. So when you put a firm layer of wax down in the form of a crayon line and then go over it with the watercolor, the watercolor gets pushed away by the waxiness. I've stirred that green a little bit more. You can see a lot more intensity in that color after I worked on it a little bit more. And you can see that waxy crayon is pushing away the water and with it the paint, so the wax will show through. It's kind of a fun way to make some textures or detail lines. So we're continuing with some wax resist, some wax wet, done wet. Hey, wait a minute, Miss Huberty. You're doing your background before you're doing your main subject. Hold on. Well, you'll notice I left that square in the middle open so I can contrast between my subject, my flowers, and my background. So most of the background I left open. I just kind of did that little bit of an edge around there. And now I'm getting into my main subject again, a little bit more wet on wet. I left my white flowers the white of the paper. Now I can think, what's going to be the best contrast? Or what's a color I didn't use much of in my main subject? I've got maybe yellow, blue, or violet, or even black. I kind of want something sunshiny and fun, so I chose yellow to fill in my background. And then, although I did use red in my subject, I didn't have a lot of the red touching that outline, so I thought that red actually might pull it all together. And some thinner red for some extra look in the background. When you're done, clean your brush out one last time, shape it gently, and of course put it away, hairy end up, so you can see which brush you have and keeps the hair nice. And ta-da! Finished watercolor.